गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अवर चैप्टर नंबर 9, द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. ओके, एंड टुडे इट्स अवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 8. ओके, दैट हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 9, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. As you know that in the previous chapter or in chapter number 7 also, we have completely studied about the magnet, effects of magnet, their properties, magnetic substances or magnetism. Okay, means the, all the things which are all around the magnet. Now in this chapter and the previous chapters which we have studied before the magnet chapters are all about the electric field, current, okay, charge. Now in this chapter, we are going to study about the combination of both the things, that is electromagnetic induction. How the electric field can be induced by the magnetic field. Okay, now in your previous chapter, we have seen that the magnetic field is associated with the moving charges and the current. Like in the Oersted experiment also we have done. And the above invention by the Oersted raised question to the scientist is the converse effect possible. Means if the moving charge particles and the current associate the magnetic field, then is the vice versa possibility is there? Means due to the magnet can a electric field can be generated? This is the question which has been raised. And means a magnetic field produce electric field which establish electric current in a closed circuit? Then all the scientists got the answer yes. Okay, they have just been conduct one experiment independently. Okay, like the Faraday is also been done some experiment, and Henry is there which has also been done some experiment. Okay, and they have just was concluded and showed that the electric current were induced in a closed coils when subjected to a varying magnetic field, and this phenomena is called electromagnetic induction. Means the electric field associated, or we can say induced by a magnetic substance, by a magnetic field. Okay, even after the experiment done by the Henry, it was not confirmed that there is an interrelationship, but they have gave many particularities of phenomena of electromagnetic induction. Means for example, the electric generator which supply electric power to our homes and workplaces works on the electromagnetic induction only, which you have studied in your 10th class also. And the electric furnace in which the metals are melt in a large amount safely and works on a electromagnetic induction also. And nowadays also there are very much use of electromagnetic induction, such as your induction stoves is popular in kitchen. Okay, and rapidly replacing the traditional stoves in this. So all this we have going to study, and the all the principles which are related to the electromagnetic induction we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, so this is all about the short intro of this chapter. Now the first topic of this chapter is magnetic flux. Magnetic flux, like of your electric flux, magnetic flux is also be there. Magnetic flux. Now as we are going to study about the magnetic flux, there is an experiment, or we are going to say that performed by Faraday and Henry, and we must have to familiar that the physical quantity like a magnetic flux which helps in a qualitative and a quantitative explanations of these experiments. And we will define magnetic flux as we have defined electric flux in our previous chapter. Okay, means in chapter number 2. So magnetic flux is a measure of number of magnetic field lines passing through a surface. Okay, the same thing is there which we have already studied in the electric flux. that is it is a measure it is a measure of number of magnetic field lines passing through a surface. Okay, suppose we have just considered the magnetic flux by d phi v through and small area element dA placed in uniform magnetic field B is d phi B is equals to B d A. Equation number 1. As we have studied already about d phi E is equals to E d A. Okay. Similarly in magnetic field also d phi B is equals to B d A. Okay. And this magnetic flux is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar quantity. The area element dA is a vector normal to its geometrical area. Normal means perpendicular. Perpendicular to its geometrical area. Okay. So, like this, we are going to explain within diagram so it, you can be better understand about this. Like, suppose this is your and particular closed area. Okay, and there are many magnetic field lines are passing and here we are just taking a perpendicular area vector. Okay, now the total magnetic flux passing through a surface
placed in magnetic field B in is summation of magnetic flux passing through all such small area elements.
Okay, so hence
flux passing through a surface is phi b, which is a summation, we can say integration of d phi b, that is b dot d, equation number 2. Okay, now here the integral consider over the surface area of a surface under consideration. Okay, and as we have just taken a special case of the magnetic flux passing through the plane surface placed in a magnetic field B, is then it will become like if we have just taken the angle. So you know dot product is there for the cos theta. Okay, so here phi B is equals to B A D A. So A it will become cos theta. Equation number 3. Okay, and now here theta is the angle between the direction of normal to the surface and magnetic field. Okay, clear? Here theta is angle between direction of normal to the surface and magnetic field B. Okay, now if this be taken as that for the maximum magnetic flux, okay, if theta is equals to 0 degree, then cos 0 is equals to 1, means both are parallel, B and A parallel, B and A are parallel, then only they are making the 0 degree angle. Okay, so the phi maximum is the maximum magnetic flux is your BA. Okay, this will be your first condition. Okay, now in the second condition, we are just be making the angle is your of 90 degree. Okay, so in the second condition, if theta is equals to 90 degree, then cos 90 is equals to 0, means B and A are normal, perpendicular to each other. Okay, so Here the flux which we have calculated is your minimum flux, phi minimum. It will become zero.
Okay, so the outgoing flux to the surface is taken as positive and the flux entering the surface is taken as negative. Remember this thing. Because the magnetic field lines are a closed curve or a loop. So the magnetic flux associated to a closed surface is always zero. Clear? So here is one note that you have to remember.
That the outgoing flux to the surface is taken as positive and flux entering the surface is taken as negative.
Okay, this is one note,
because the magnetic flux, the field lines, the magnetic field lines are closed curve or a loop, so the total magnetic flux associated to a closed surface is always zero. That is, a closed integration of B dot dA is equals to zero. And this equation number 4. Okay, this is called the Gauss law for magnetism. This is called Gauss law for magnetism. Okay, and you know that the magnetic flux is a scalar quantity. Now the dimensional formula. Its dimensional, just make it underline, the Gauss law for magnetism. Sometimes they will be asked about this directly, what is the Gauss law of magnetism. Okay, so its dimensional formula is this, you have to be calculate. Okay, and its SI unit is Weber, that is WB, or Tesla meter square, that is your TM square. Okay, clear? Now if we are going to discuss about its CGS unit, unit of magnetic flux in CGS is Maxwell, denoted by Mx. Okay, clear? If you are going to relate them, then always remember that the one Weber is equals to 1 volt/s, or we can say 10^8 amu of potential, and that amu of potential is your Maxwell. Clear? Okay. So this is about it. Now, one example we are going to solve it out. Okay. And the question for the example is, a circular coil of area 3i cap plus j cap plus 2k cap into 10^-2 meter square is placed in a magnetic field that is 2i cap minus 2k cap into 10^4 tesla. Find out magnetic flux passing through the coil. Okay. Now, its solution is that there is a area of a circular coil is given in the question, and its magnetic field is also be given in the question. You have to be calculate the magnetic flux. So simply, we have used the formula that is phi is equals to BA. Okay, this formula has been used. So phi B is equals to B dot A. So phi is equals to, first we have to put the values. Magnetic flux is your 2i cap minus 2k cap into 10^4 dot product with the area, that is your 3i cap plus j cap plus 2k cap into 10^-2. Now, if we are going to solve it out, so phi is equals to, going to solve it out, then 8 6 minus 4, 10^-6, it's minus 4, okay? -6 Weber. So it will become phi is equals to 2 into 10^-6 Weber. This will be your answer. Okay. Now we are going to study about our next topic, and our next topic is our electromagnetic induction. That is the name of our chapter. Okay. And for the description of the electromagnetic induction, we will first study about the three experiments carried out independently by the Faraday and the Henry. Just simply, we are going to understand about the different phenomena related to the electromagnetic induction, which are based on those experiments. Okay? So, in the series of this, the first experiment is experiment number one. Okay, so First of all, I will draw the diagram, so it will be easy for you just to understand it. Here is our a galvanometer. G. Okay, and here a coils are there. Okay. Coils are there, and we are just simply put or kept a magnetic bar. A magnet bar, magnet is there of a north pole and the south pole. Okay. And the field lines are just passing through it. They are not intersecting to each other. This you know it very well. Okay, so the magnetic field lines are passing through it. This is the coil and this is your bar magnet. Okay, now first of all we have to be consider a closed circuit of a galvanometer and a coil, and here coil is not connected with any surface of EMF or that is your cell or a battery. The north pole of a bar magnet is kept towards the coil. Now as we move north pole of the magnet towards the coil, the pointer of the galvanometer shows reflection. But as the north pole of a bar magnet is moved away from the coil, the pointer of the galvanometer deflects but in a opposite direction. Clear? This you know it very well. Okay, that's question we had just be done in that Orchard experiment also, not like exactly like this but similar. Okay, now if a south pole of a bar magnet is moved towards or away from the coil, the deflection or the direction of a deflection in the galvanometer is opposite to the direction of the deflection from the motion of the north pole. And if the magnet moves faster towards or away from the magnet, relatively a large deflection is observed. And if the bar magnet is held fixed and the coil C is moved towards or away from the coil, same effects are observed. Okay, it doesn't matter that the magnet is moving away or towards the coil, or the coil is moving away or towards the magnet. The deflection observation will be the same. And however, when the coil and bar magnet both remain stationary, then the galvanometer shows no deflection because they are in a rest condition at that time. So, okay, so this is your first experiment. Okay, clear? Simple as that. Now moving toward the next experiment, that is your experiment number second. So, second number experiment. Experiment number 2. Now, in this experiment, again, we are going to first draw the diagram so it will be better for you just to understand it. Okay. So, first of all, again, I am just draw a galvanometer circuit. Okay, along with that just kept the coil Okay, coil is there. Near to it, I am just replacing one another coil. Okay, and in this coil, instead of a galvanometer, I am placing a battery. Okay, so here the positive terminal and here your negative terminal. And again, we are just making it like here we will make a positive and make it negative. Okay, then only direction will be good. Like this. Okay, now again here the coil is there. A second coil, that is your C2. Now this coil we are just removing. So in this the current is passing, so the magnetic field also be produced. So I'm just be drawing that magnetic field lines through it. This will be the first one diagram. Second one is also be like this. Galvanometer is placed. And a coil is there. Okay. And here a circuit is there, but this time it was open, not closed. Okay, and here again the coil has been kept, so they are just be simply denoted by the dotted line. Okay. Now in the second experiment, a bar magnet is replaced by the another coil C2 which is connected with the cell. And when a coil C2 is having a current towards or away from the coil C1, the same effect has been observed as in the experiment number 1 we have observed. Now when the coil C2 is brought towards the galvanometer of C1, shows some deflection, and when coil C2 is brought away from C1, galvanometer shows some deflection in opposite direction. Okay, now if the coil C2 is held fixed and coil C1 moves, deflection is observing in galvanometer. When both coils C1 and C2 are held fixed, then there will be no deflection is observed in the galvanometer. The same thing is there which we have done in the previous one. So this is a diagram for the induced current due to the motion of C2, and in this induced current in C1 due to the change in the current in C2. Clear? Okay. Now in the experiment number 3, the above two experiments involved in the relative motion between the magnet and the coil and between the two coils. But Faraday showed that for electromagnetic induction, relative motion is not an absolute requirement. If both coils C1 and C2 remain stationary and the key is connected to coil C2 is pressed, there is a momentary deflection in galvanometer, and when the key is released, there is again a momentary deflection in the galvanometer, but now in opposite direction. Okay, and when the key is pressed continuously, okay, then there is no deflection for the galvanometer. okay, clear? So deflection in the galvanometer increase when the number of turns of the coil increase and soft iron rod is replaced inside the coil. Okay, so this is all about the three experiments. The diagram of this one experiment I have drawn here. Okay, previously I have drawn the diagram. Okay, so this one for the previous one, experiment number one. This is for experiment number two, and this one is for experiment number three. Now the conclusion from the experiment, the Faraday explained the result of experiment on the basis of the magnetic flux. And according to Faraday, when magnetic flux is associated with the coil, varies an EMF is induced in coil due to which the current is also induced. Okay, so the phenomena of developing the induced EMF in a coil due to the variation of magnetic flux through the coil is called the electromagnetic induction. This is the simple as that. So I'm just writing its definition in the note form. The diagram of third experiment previously I have made both the diagrams in together. Okay, so here from you can write, and you have to be write the theory of this experiment by your own. Okay, so the phenomena of developing induced EMF in coil due to variation in magnetic flux through the coil is called electromagnetic induction, EMI. Okay, so this is about the electromagnetic induction. Now the next topic is your Faraday law of electromagnetic induction that we have to be done in our next lecture. Okay, and before it I am just giving you one question for the numerical for your homework that you have to be solved. Okay, and here the question. A circular coil is placed in a magnetic field 5×10³ Tesla at 60° angle to the field. If the area of coil is 4 m², then find the amount of magnetic flux through the coil. Okay, so a circular coil is there which has been placed in a magnetic field. So value of magnetic field has been given, angle between them has been given, and area is also given in the question. Simply you have to be put it in the form. Remember that the angle is in between the normal of a plane of a coil and direction of the magnetic field.
this angle of 60 degree is not with that. So 90 minus 60, 30 degree angle is there. Okay, the value of angle is 30 degree. Remember this thing. This is a conceptual question. Clear? Okay. So the next topic we are going to discuss in our next lecture. Thank you. That's all for today.